In this video, let's have a look at the fluid ROM for the Poco X3 Pro. The specialty of this ROM is that it is liquid smooth. Let me show you. First of all, this is the stock launcher that this ROM comes with. And this is quite different from the Pixel launcher. And here are the options that you get here, as you can see. You can also show a grid of apps if you want. This is how it will look. And you can also use taskbar at the bottom. And you have suggestion options here. So this is how the taskbar will look at the bottom. And here are the wallpaper options. As you can see here, there are no wallpaper and style options like Pixel rooms. So that is a bummer. And there's also no select option available here like Pixel based rooms. And let's go into the settings. And here are the gesture settings that you get. You can quickly open the camera if you want. You have system navigation options like this. Not much options present. And you have the 100 mode. And you can use that if you want. You can also press and hold for assistant. You have swipe to screenshot, press and hold, quick touch, prevent ringing. And do note that this ROM does not come inbuilt with Google Apps. You will have to separately flash them. And here are the fluid customization options. You can enable the dark theme from here if you want. So basically the mono settings here doesn't do anything. That will probably be added in future versions of the ROM. And you have clock options. You can change up the format of the date if you want. You have traffic indicator options, as you can see here. And these are the options present. And you have icon manager as well. You have combined signal icons, small mobile type icons. You can customize the quick settings as well. As you can see here, these are the options. You have system level tweaks, as you can see here, and you have some miscellaneous options here. Here you have the display section. You can quickly change the font here, but there are only two options. And you can also customize for the things like nightlight if you want, and you can also schedule it. You have three color profiles available here: natural, boosted, and adaptive. And you also have this option for smooth display to automatically switch from 60 to 120 hertz, but you cannot really customize it further. Like in other rooms, you can basically set the display at say 60 hertz or at 120 hertz all the time. But that thing is basically not present here. So overall, what I really liked about this ROM was that this is a really lightweight ROM, which makes it really fluid to use, no pun intended. And overall, I love this ROM's speed per se, in terms of the animations and in terms of how this ROM handles itself in day-to-day usage, and it is really fast. And even the battery life is quite great. I'm getting about 1.2% screen out drain here. That is a bit on the higher side compared to other rooms, but the screen on time has been quite solid. As you can see from here, the active drain is only around 11.38%, which is pretty great. So overall, I'm quite happy with this room, but one thing that I did not like was that there aren't really that many features, but that will be changing in the future because this is kind of a work in progress room, as you could see from the Mono Engine settings. But overall, if you want a smooth room for the day-to-day usage, really smooth ROM and with a little bit of a different UI, then you can go for this particular ROM if you want. So that's it for this video. If you liked it, click on the like button and also subscribe to my channel for more such videos.